move on to the Indian elections now. And well, we've seen all kinds of rhetoric during this campaign, particularly from the BJP led by the Prime Minister on national security issues, whether it has been asking for votes in the name of the soldiers killed in Pulwama or on the Balakot strikes or talking about Wing Commander Abhinandan. But now the Prime Minister has made headlines in the last 24 hours, raising his anti-Pakistan pitch to a new level, where he said in Barmer on Sunday that India is not scared of Pakistan's nuclear threat anymore. That does Pakistan think our nuclear button is for Diwali? It is the first time that we're seeing an Indian Prime Minister talk about India's nuclear arsenal and the option of actually using these nuclear weapons in an election campaign in that way. And the question is whether that is something that should be done at all. Let's listen to what the Prime Minister said.
Bharat ne Pakistan ki dhamki se darne ki niti ko chhod diya. Ye theek kiya na maine? Warna aaye din हमारे पास न्यूक्लियर बटन है, न्यूक्लियर बटन है, न्यूक्लियर, यही कहते थे. हमारे अखबार वाले भी लिखते थे पाकिस्तान के पास भी न्यूक्लियर है. तो हमारे पास क्या है भाई, ये दिवाली के लिए रखा है क्या?
Well, lots of controversy over what the Prime Minister has said. And Ambassador KC Singh, you led that criticism actually. And tell us more about why you think that this is not healthy, that this is just something Mr. Modi should not have done.
Nidhi, look, 1998, when we tested, I was the spokesman of the ministry. Then Pakistan tested within 2 weeks, and the whole world was here saying we're irresponsible states. Kashmir is a flashpoint. There'll be a nuclear war here. And that is from where the Vajpayee government and Mr. Brajesh Mishra created the nuclear doctrine. And the doctrine was that, look, ours is a no first use. It's a minimum credible deterrent. We are not going to hit anyone. We'll certainly not hit any country which does not have nuclear weapons, etc., etc. So the basic idea was that this is really for deterrence. This is not for nuclear war fighting. We are not going to be starting a nuclear war. And this is the way the doctrine continued. We tweaked it in 2003, saying even if there's a biological attack, we can still retain the right of a massive counter-attack using nuclear weapons. But that is where it stayed. 2010 summit between President Obama and President Manmohan Singh, they reiterated this, that both countries will continue to work towards emphasizing non-use of nuclear weapons. So India has been a votary at the head of a movement towards disarmament. Because we said nuclear weapons, we were forced to acquire them. It is not something that we desired or we display as Diwali patakas. These are something which we need for India's security. And as the more powerful nation, we don't want to go on threatening other countries with it. And more significantly, we got China. And the Chinese have a no first use doctrine. They're the only major power which have stuck to a no first use doctrine since 1964. So what is the signal we are sending to the Chinese? We are destabilizing a certain nuclear stability which has persisted since 99. And of course, it's always been known to Pakistan that if they make any mischief, we will retaliate. And over a period of time, we develop the triad. We are even capable of launching a missile from the submarines or from the aeroplanes or with the missiles. You build up your capability. It's known to Pakistan, but you do not take it to the election rallies and start using it. What will the rest of the world think of you? Kim Jong-un of DPRK does it, North Korea. He goes threatening people. Pakistan goes threatening people. And you want to join the nuclear suppliers group? You want to be a permanent member of the Security Council? Then start behaving like one.
Well, that's a very important point you've made. And I want to take this next question to Pawan Verma, who is, of course, a senior leader of the JDU, a close ally of the BJP, but has also been a diplomat. And Mr. Verma, you know, your thoughts on what the Prime Minister has said. Was this an irresponsible comment to have made? Are we now, you know, going to be talking about nuclear war so casually in our election campaigns?
Well, Nidhi, I think what the Prime Minister intended to say was that the use of terrorism by Pakistan against us and our ability to retaliate against it. In the past, the restraining factor was that there are two nuclear powers facing each other, and that you cannot escalate even a conventional conflict to a point where it could be a trigger to a nuclear warfare. And so, therefore, that was a restraining factor on us. But post-Balakot, we've showed that within the parameters of conventional warfare, responding to terrorist bases attacking India, we can use force. And so he was trying to say that the fact that Pakistan and India are nuclear power should not be a deterrent to our taking the right steps against terrorism sponsored by Pakistan. But I agree with you that to talk of nuclear warfare casually or even flippantly is not right. We are living as part of an international system where India has been one of the greatest votaries of nuclear disarmament. We have declared a no first use policy, and therefore to speak of it as an option that we could utilize even in the context of a metaphor like they are not, what we have is not Diwali Patakas, was perhaps avoidable. But we must understand the context in which the Prime Minister made the statement.
Well, you are seeing a context, but you know, like you said, at the end of the day, you can't agree with the, you know, issuing a nuclear threat so casually. And Professor Sanjeev Tiwari is with us. He's a political analyst. You're sympathetic to the BJP, Professor Tiwari. There is one thing to use national security as part of the election campaign, which Mr. Modi has done repeatedly. Was this taking it a step too far?
No, it's not a step too far. It's basically the reaction what the Pakistan and the Pakistani Prime Minister, he talked on the 26th of February 2019 and the meeting which was held on 27th of February 2019. Not only that, in the meeting he also called that the nuclear weapon which Pakistan is possessing is not for the showpiece. It's not for the things to decorate in the dining table, drawing halls. And that is why the Indian Prime Minister, he reacted, number one. Number two, you see the contest of the Prime Minister when he
so
was talking.
So, Mr. Modi has reacted to what Imran Khan apparently said on 27th of February
of
on
course,
the…
Of course, the reactions are there.
What was yesterday? 21st of April.
Yeah. Number one. Number two, Nidhi, is that when you will when you'll show the world and the Pakistan that our hands are tired and we are not going to use the nuclear weapon at any point of moment, at any point, whatever you will do. That they have done it on the 26th, 11th, 2008. What our forces were doing, they could not retaliate. More than 300 people they were killed, and the entire country was looking on the entire nation and the forces.
167 now, were killed, including the terrorists.
Anyway, that could be the exaggeration. That could be because I don't have the facts just now. Sure. But it was around 200 people who were killed, and the entire nation was witness the type of.
So we should threaten
number
nuclear
one. Number
war,
two,
which
at
could
that
kill
time,
our own
at
people.
That time, the government has failed to retaliate, and that is why they have taken another relation and the Pulwama. It was followed by the surgical strike, and then their strike is there. That means the Prime Minister is trying to say its people that don't worry, the strong nation
that I will
is there,
use nuclear
the strong
weapons,
leader,
it will kill you also.
Here.
They'll kill all of us also. You do realize that,
no? Not at all.
I mean,
don't
is
worry
this something
that.
To be
you
taken
be
so
killed.
Lightly to
you
use
won't
on,
be killed.
Is this something that should be used on an
election
campaign
trail? The type of rhetoric the Pakistan...
India wants to be part of the NSG, the Nuclear Suppliers Group.
Nidhi,
and this is exactly what will be held against us by countries
Nidhi,
like China and others tomorrow.
The rhetoric the Pakistan is making every
Are
time.
We Pakistan?
No, we are not Pakistan.
And are we not a bigger power and democracy?
The mother of all the nuclear power, and that is why we want to say clearly, our leaders want to say clearly, see, it's not the India of yesteryear. It's the India of today, which is the new India, which is having the capability to do anything. And don't try to play with our sentiments and our soldiers.
Let me get Maya into this and then Ashwarya. Maya.
So a couple
this
of things.
This is a new India.
This
in
is a new India. I think it was an extremely irresponsible statement by the Prime Minister. I don't think any leader, he's still the Prime Minister, he's not just a political candidate. I don't think any leader of a responsible nuclear nation, irrespective of the domestic compulsions or the domestic audience, can make a statement like this. Because we can sit in a TV studio and say, but you know, he didn't mean it, or he was just being rhetorical. But the person who's in the audience listening to him is not deconstructing his statement in the same way that we are. That's one. The second point is, time after time we hear, but Pakistan says, do we want to be Pakistan? Do we want to follow that line of argument, that line of conversation? Because we've all established that every time Imran Khan says that, oh, we want Prime Minister Modi to come back to power, what is he saying? He is essentially saying, let there be a populist, majoritarian, you know, warmongering prime minister in India, if it comes to that, because that justifies our rhetoric and our warmongering on the Pakistani side. Is that the kind of conversation we want in the subcontinent? I think, you know, elections aside, elections come every 5 years. In our case, they come sometimes more often than 5 years. Are we going to reduce foreign policy, which is built on really strong tenets, which has, you know, continuity at its fundamental core, responsibility as a global leader, are we going to reduce it to election rhetoric? I mean, forget the election commission, forget the Congress and the BJP in this. As a citizen of India, I want to know, can I go anywhere in the world and say, my prime minister did not mean what he said, but why do I have to explain that?
Professor why Tiwari, am I in this position where I have to explain this?
No, I just want to react to, respond to Maya ji. When she was talking about warmongering prime minister, he's not warmongering prime minister. He never ever went on himself and
what
fought
is this?
The war.
I'm saying this language
no.
is that of warmongering.
No, that is what. The language which you used just now, you see that is the slip of the language or slip of the tongue. But when you'll see that which type of party Congress is, when it's always talk about the proofs of the what our soldiers did, the proof of their bravery, then what you'll do in this election time?
When did they ask for the proof, by the way?
Yeah, of course they have been when? Asking. They have always been talking ill about the soldiers.
How?
Yeah, I will give you some of the proofs. They basically talks about that our what do you call it, the chief of our air force is the street goon. That was on the record. That is on the record.
Who said that?
The Congress leaders.
Who
Congress
is leaders. Do you have a name? A date?
Yeah, date is not here, but I have
who's
the report.
The
I have the
it?
Report. You can I can give it to
no,
you.
No, whose report is that? Is that the, from the WhatsApp the, University or is there a quote?
No. It's basically the report of the newspaper and the media
so
houses like
you. The point is
I'm coming to that. I will give you whose report is that. It's basically a report which was published from the different newspapers which
no,
I
but
took.
Who said it? I mean the point
basically
is
it's the Congress leader themselves who allies that the
Aishwarya Mahadev.
Yeah.
You know, Nidhi, what has happened is that we've seen the Prime Minister stoop to unimaginable lows in this election, and this is just one more of them. For every time that the Congress is held responsible at a higher standard, if the nation and the BJP itself decided to hold their Prime Minister to that, I feel like he would have no place here. When you talk about things such as war and this chest-thumping jingoism that is doing the rounds during these elections, things such as talking about a nuclear bomb, you know, they think it's like small thing, you don't realize the fallout and whatnot. What you need to realize, the Congress party is the one that is ensured that even though we're not part of the NPT, we still have nuclear power. We still were allowed the 1-2-3 agreement. We still have civilian nuclear power supply because of the UPA government. And what you're talking about now is very akin to what Kim Jong-il and Kim Jong-un of the DPRK would do. We are this close from being branded a rogue nation in a nuclear environment because if you look at the subcontinent, that is the sort of situation we're in. And these are things, election or not, on a global platform, this does not make Narendra Modi anything different from a Kim Jong-un or Erdogan or even Donald Trump for that matter, because he seems to be talking out of a hat completely full of fallacious news and for electioneering, absolutely.
But you know, Pawan Varma, context aside, which you tried to give us earlier, you know, Mr. Modi has to at the end of the day remember, and would you agree with this, that he's still the Prime Minister of India. He's not the Prime Minister of the BJP. He's not just a BJP leader.
He's my Prime Minister.
Yeah, he's everybody's Prime Minister. So there has to be a certain sense of responsibility that must come with statements that are made.
You know, I think the Prime Minister could have said the same thing in different language.
Yeah.
He could have said that India is a strong power. India is a nuclear weapon power. We do not want to be the first to use nuclear weapons, but in self-defense, if required, no country should take India lightly. I can imagine a statement like that, but I think the metaphor used was that we have nuclear weapons which are not only for dhamakas on Diwali, can be interpreted to be a threat for the use of nuclear weapons, which I'm sure the Prime Minister would be introspecting about himself. I don't believe that was his intent, but it was worded in language which can be interpreted in a different manner, both by nations who are watching India and by neutral observers who believe
Pakistan,
India's cause
rally
of towards nuclear disarmament.
Well, you shouldn't have to say it at all. You shouldn't exactly. I think the point that Pawan Verma is making is that countries around the world are going to watch this, and they're going to latch on to what was said. So this you know, sometimes I think our political leaders have to remember that, you know, elections will come and go, but what they say on the campaign trail is something that's going to have a lasting impact.